myself, Dr. Ratish. I'm a practicing interventional cardiologist in Kaveri Multispeciality Hospital, Mysore. I like to discuss few points about heart in COVID times and what actually happens to the heart disease and what are the precautions one has to take in COVID times. One can check his heart is healthy or not by getting few tests like ECG, echocardiography, and treadmill tests done every year, especially after the age of 35 years. And also other parameters like regular blood pressure checking and control of sugars and his renal parameters will help in deciding whether he will develop heart disease or not. Yes, of course, a perfectly healthy heart can develop heart attack, especially in patients who smoke or exposed to the high levels of air pollution. The blood clots in the blood vessels of the heart will be found within a few hours of exposure to the smoke. And same is the case in patients with the diabetes, who are hypertensive, who are uncontrolled, and also the patients who are having high levels of cholesterol. Yes, sometimes before having a massive heart attack, patient may feel an undue fatigue and excessive sweating, and also some amount of dizziness. These may be some warning symptoms before having a massive heart attacks. And also some patients may develop angina-like symptoms like on and off chest pain or breathlessness or difficulty in breathing, which on increases on exertion. These are the preliminary symptoms of patients who develop a massive heart attacks. Heart blockages are of two types. One is the patient can develop a blood clots which occurs immediately, and on a chronic type, the patients can develop atherosclerosis stenosis, which causes angina. One can easily monitor blood pressure at home by getting a blood pressure measuring digital machine, which you can regularly measure it once a daily. If high blood pressure is not treated, one can develop acutely stroke, heart attacks, and renal failure, that is kidney problems. Hypertension will be a double whammy when it is uncontrolled. First of all, it was one of the prime causes of development of blockages in the heart. And secondly, hypertension causes increased muscle mass in the heart, which in turn increases the oxygen need for the heart. So, in view of already having the blockages with increased oxygen demand, the patient can develop angina and heart attack very easily. The most common risk factor is age. As we age, our blood vessels will become less elastic and more stiffer, and most of us will going to develop high blood pressure. Other causes of blood pressure are chronic kidney disease, hormonal problems like thyroid disorders, growth hormone disorders, and also some patients can develop familial hypertension. There will be a development of hypertension very early in young age. Sleep and cardiovascular is directly related. The quality of the sleep you're getting while you sleep, which affects the health of the heart. The disorders like obstructive sleep apnea will cause us development of hypertension, diabetes, and also stenosis or blockages in the heart. Yes, of course, COVID-19, as it attacks the lungs, it also attacks the myocardial cells of the heart. It's causing myocarditis, which in turn decreases the function of the heart and leading to the heart failures and also arrhythmias. The patients who are already having a compromised heart can further develop repeated heart attacks because COVID-19 itself is a hypercoagulability state. And also, those patients who are already having a compromised heart, further infection of the heart from the coronavirus will cause myocarditis and further decreases the heart capacity, leading to the further complications like heart failures and arrhythmias. COVID-19 itself is a hypercoagulability state. So in those patients who are having a already compromised heart, one has to give adequate doses of blood thinners like antiplatelets and heparins. Previously, there were some reports of those patients who are taking ACE inhibitors are developing a very serious form of infection or more chances of getting infection. But over the due course of the times, such theory is ruled out. There is no evidence as far as now that any of the antihypertensive drugs should be withheld. Those patients who are on follow-up and those patients who are not able to reach the hospital or unnecessary visits to the hospital can be avoided for a few months who are completely asymptomatic or who are doing well. They can regularly check their blood pressures at home and also blood sugars at home. In these stress times, take adequate quantities of fruits, vegetables, low salt diets, and also exercise regularly, especially at least for 40 minutes per day of brisk walking every day, at least 5 days a week. And also do breathing exercises, meditation to keep you are out of stress. If you are a heart disease patient, get your blood tests done regularly and also check your blood pressures and monitor at home and lead a healthy living heart life.